Hey guys, and welcome back to another YouTube video. So in today's video, I'm gonna be working with the model tkinter, and we are gonna be creating this really cool temperature finding, weather finding app. It's gonna be a GUI app, and yeah, and we are also gonna be making an executable out of it. So this is the actually executable. Let me actually show you. By the time at the end, we will have created an application out of this. So yeah. So the cool thing is I can just put any place over here. So if I say for India and I get weather, it will tell me what it is. So 59 degree Fahrenheit, ignition and mist. If I search for even something like Antarctica, it will work. So it's currently not the best weather in Antarctica, and you can just scale it in a bit and it won't freak out. That's kind of cool. Like, if I just scale it something like this, the screen won't freak out. So that's good. So it's about 50 lines of code, 60 lines of code, and yeah, so that's that. That's what I want to say. Alright, so yeah. So let me actually go ahead and make a new file, and then we will get Kraken. So let me actually do that. New 5.5. Let's just go tutorial. So open that up, and let me just go ahead and create a configuration. So this is PyCharm specific. If you're working with any other IDE or etc., you don't need to. Just telling that Python. Tutorial. Let me just create that. Where is that? Okay, so I've done that, and we have a config for that, and we have our app dot right away. So this is what we will do. So I'm just gonna go and get code. I'm gonna import tkinter as tk, and I'm also gonna be using the message box module from tkinter to create a cool little message box every time like we press that button. Tkinter, I'm just gonna go ahead and import the message box. So now I got the two imports. So even if you want this sort of Monokai theme, this is actually Monokai and PyCharm. You can actually do it. Just go to file settings and then go to color theme, and you can actually change it, because I just find it's pretty good. And we will also need the request module of Python, because we are actually going to be working with an API, which you can have a look over here, which is the key and the URL, and it's actually an API, so that's why. So now I'm just gonna go ahead and make the root. So I'm simply gonna go root equals to tk.tk, and now I'm just gonna make the main. So I'm just gonna go root dot title, do the title. So I'm just gonna go weather finding app tutorial, and I'm just gonna go root dot main. Alright, so now I'm just gonna go and simply make the canvas. So make the canvas. So I'm just gonna go canvas equals to tk dot canvas. Also, if you wanna check out like which variables you have used, just go to the structure and check just in case your code isn't running and you don't get the desired. I'm just gonna go to the height of height and the width of width. Now this is what we are going to be defining at top, obviously. So that's just what we will do. So I'm just going to go variables. Let us go width equals. Let me have a look. So and height will be 500. So that's that. Now let me just back it to the screen by simply tapping up canvas.back, and it should work. Let me just quickly run the file. Alright, there it is. So we got the file, we got this little cool window. Yeah, this is the size that we want. Now I'm just gonna go ahead and make the frame. So, actually, let me keep my executable out. Let me just keep this one out so you guys can quickly have a look if you want. Alright, so I'm just gonna go ahead and make the frame. So if you just go ahead and look at it, we got one frame at the top and the second frame over here at the bottom. I got a button, we got some entries, that's how it works. You can see sometimes it's just a little bit slow, but that's because it's an executable, so don't worry about that. Let me get rid of that. Okay, so frame. I'm simply gonna go frame. So tk.name, and we're gonna go into root pg of sky blue and media file. Now you can obviously play around with the background color and the border. You can also go and put some hexadecimal values, but I am not doing that. And I'm simply gonna go frame.case. Let's just put these in. Let me just put these in height. I'm gonna make the real height something 0.15, and I'm gonna give the real width will be equal to 0.9. So the real x will be equal to 0.05. Just simple math. And I think I'm gonna give it a real y or something like 0.05. But I think I've already removed that. I don't know. We'll check. And I feel like the same is the best, so I'm just gonna change it. So now it's time to make the entry. So make the entry. To do that, all we do is just about entry equals to tk.entry. And I'm simply just going to place it in the frame, and it will have a font size of 4. You could go with the default font size of the entry, but it's kind of small, so that's why. And you could go ahead and give it a background and a foreground color with a BG and FG, or I don't like it. So. And I can just simply go into that place, and let me just give it a little bit of. And this is 0.6, and the height of 4. There we go. Do that, run the code, and there we go. We have our entry. So that's that. Now I'm just gonna make the. I'm simply gonna go button equals to tk.button. Which is obviously going to be in the frame, and it will have a text of get with do that, and I'm simply going to go button.place. So button.place. Although if you can wrap around all of this around your head, go check out my tkinter tutorial. It's like making that secret diary in Python. That's the tkinter tutorial. Go check that out. I will explain you how the message box works, but that's that. I'm just gonna go put in the place. Right. One. And width of 0.35. And it's a length of 0.65. Alright, I think that should work. Let me run the code. Let me just decrease the length. 163. This will, I think, work a bit better. 0.6. Alright, this actually works a lot. So you can type things and click the button. So we got that all done. So now let's just make the lower frame. So make the lower frame. Something like lower underscore frame equals to tk.frame. Something the root pg of right for that. It's your sky blue, and also a PDF file, because I don't want that. And also, if I would like not put any video, then it will like not look inconsistent. That's why. And it also looks like really bad without borders. So that's why. And I'm simply gonna go logo frame dot place, obviously. Logo frame dot place. The height is going to be 0.55. Let's just go 6. These are width 0.9, and these are left with 0.05, and these are y will be 0.3. Oh my god. Okay. So 0.9. Alright. Oh, I turned on the number by mistake. 0.3. Alright, we got that. And it's time to make the label. So make the label equals to tk dot label in the lower underscore frame, and we gotta go to text right now. This will the temperature and weather of the place. Alright, put that, and I'm just gonna go label dot place, label dot place. I'm simply gonna go width equals 1 and height equals 1. As we have the background of Y, it's not gonna be like completely occupied. So that's that. So we got the entire structure ready. Now we actually need the function. So there we go. There we go. So we got the entire structure ready. So I'm just gonna go ahead and first make a test function. So that's fine. I'm gonna pass it the parameter of the entry, and I'm simply gonna go ahead and print. Button collect, and I'm simply gonna bind. So I'm just gonna command. Now we could directly put it, but I like to put it in a lambda expression. Lambda is just doing an error. Oh, I got it. I was pressing two buttons, it's not working. Why? It's why is it doing that? Let me copy that and paste it to the right somewhere. There's that. Got that over there. And now let me just go ahead and run the code and see how it works. Let me actually show you. So if I just run the code now, and I just click the button, you can see it will print out button created. That's awesome. Alright, so now it's time for the real complicated part. So I'm actually going to be copy pasting this function, because it's like this is like pretty complicated, like not complicated, it has these huge URLs which I don't obviously know, like who remembers URLs. So that's why I'm copying them. So I'm simply gonna go down and paste it, so you guys can copy that by this time. Copy it real quick. Now let me just run the code. Let me just have a look over here. Alright. Let me run the code. So if I put in a place. Alright, I just forgot something. I need to put get better. Let's just put any place. Alright. Let's put. Let me put some really like place that are not a lot of people know. Yemen. Alright. Let's just go Slovakia. Alright. That's good, that's good. Finland. Ooh, that's good, that's good. Let's just go Norway. I think it will be cold over there. Let's see. Oh, alright, you know. A little bit cold, not too much. So that's that. So this is the entire app, but as I told you, we are gonna be using the message box. So whenever we are gonna be clicking the button. Look at what I will simply just type out message box dot show info, and I'm simply gonna type out temperature retrieve. And actually I'm keeping this a glance today and type of that away so let me just show me. And you will see it opens that up. Temperature retrieved. So actually let me just put some actual name. It'll print it will like throw that little sound. Print that out and yeah. So you can also go ahead and make some show warning. I'll like throw that exclamation sign in yellow below. Like put that temperature. But obviously we don't want to do that, so I'm just gonna find this. And I'm just gonna put details. There we go. So I'm pretty sure this is all I wanted to do in this video. Obviously we need to now convert it to an executable, so that's what I'm doing now. So once you do that, now we actually need to convert this to an executable, so any person not having Python will not have this. So for that, you first need to open up your terminal. So just go inside about cmd. Also, you need to have Python 3.7, so just 3.8. So open that up, but I'm going to be using the integrated terminal in Python. So now all you need to do is just type up pyinstaller. Now I've already done that, so I'm going to skip that step. And then you just need to type out pyinstaller and just hit enter. Now you should get something that looks like this. Usage and all of that. So what you need to do now is just type out pyinstaller -15 -w. Now, if you have a console app like which is run on the Python console, then you don't do that. Or install it. Okay, and then you just put the name of the file. Oh, yeah, so which in our case is tutorial.com. So now, as soon as you press enter, it will do it. Thank you. So it will search through all of this. It takes some time sometimes. I'm gonna not pause the video just to show you guys, if you just in case if you guys get any error. So that's why. So you should get some stuff that pops up like a lot of applications that you can do. And you should, if you get something like completed successfully, then it's working. Now, once you do that, you should get this full of the list. And it should have the file called the call. Now, it should be quite a large file. Like, it's not too large, but still, like, the size that you would be expecting from it. So now you just double click it and it should work. So if I, so as I'm not making this up, let's just search in top different. And you can see how it works. So now you can just move it into a desktop or whatever. And I'm also going to be showing you a really cool trick that you can like, I don't know, like we don't need that actually. I thought we would, but we don't need it. So there you go, you have created a really cool app that you can actually release because it's like fully functional. It's not like it's some part of it, it's not working. It's fully functional. So yeah, so that is for this app. It was, you know, pretty awesome, and I feel like you would have a really good understanding of the MessageBox module as well as all of this API stuff. So yeah, if you want to know more about this API, just go over here, copy this and paste it in your web browser and it will work. So you do that and it will work, like that's how it's done, because that's just like the entire link URL. So you know, this is the entire app. I hope you like this. It's pretty cool. This was like my first Python project. It was like actual window. Like it was not that text-based project. So I was pretty proud of it. So yeah. So this is the entire thing. Let me actually open that up just to show you guys the API. That and let me just paste this entire thing over here and I'll just connect and die. Now this like open weather map provides API for this, so that's why they it's not like sponsored or anything, it's like they provide. So alright. So I feel like they would have just signed in some sort of development or something, I don't know. So I will post this code on GitHub because I feel like some people like just want to some people just want to get the entire finished result first and then they see if they want to do that or not. So don't worry, I will obviously put that on GitHub and you'll be able to do that. So yeah, so that's it for today guys. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, like and subscribe to the channel, and until the next time we meet, bye.